Welcome, everyone, to our 18th episode of Stories of Faith. I'm Pastor Doug, and glad that you are with me today. We are talking about a missional faith. A missional faith, it is a nature of faith to be sent. Once we receive Jesus as Lord and Savior, He sends us. We go on mission. That is the purpose of our life. The distance isn't important. You can go 100 feet or 10,000 miles. It's the place and the people that is important. Where He has put you is what we really are concerned about. Matthew 4, Jesus says, "Come, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." Later He says, "Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into His harvest field." J. Oswald Smith of The Last Generation wrote to leaders a lot, says, "The church that does not evangelize will fossilize." In other words, we'll calcify unless we are sent, unless we move. So as soon as we come into relationship with Jesus, He moves us. Every sending in our faith is a challenge. And it's a challenge that we hopefully grow in and through. In the Bible, mission is always done with others. Our missional faith is first of all relational. Our mission is too big to do alone, and too important to try not to do together. We must do it together. And that's why I'm really pleased that today I get to be with Dr. Wayne and with Timothy. Both of these guys have been sent. Both these guys have been involved in mission. By the way, how did you guys meet? How do you guys know each other?
Well, Tim used to always hang out with my daughter Julie and husband Conrad at church, and they used to go out to lunch after service, and so I always knew Tim from there, and I ended up discipling him because what happened about 2 years ago, I was being discipled by Pastor Ron and with about 11 other people, and one of the things that Pastor Ron did ask is for us to try to carry it one more further generation by asking
to
disciple someone else. So I asked Tim if he wanted to be discipled.
Yeah, that's pretty much the way it happened. When I first came here, I got to know Conrad first, actually, who's Julie's husband now. And we kind of developed a relationship, and then once she came into his life, got more connected with them, got more connected to the whole Tofukuji clan, as it were. Got to meet up with them, spend a lot of time with Dr. Wayne and Marsha, sit with them in church, and our relationship developed from there.
Yeah. So it's all about relationship, and even as Jesus called the disciples, right? He calls one, and the other one goes, gets his brother, right? So Andrew goes and gets Peter, and we watched all of them go and invite someone else into the relationship. That's what it's all about. So you guys just kind of knew each other, attended church together, and then you got to know each other better. So when you have met together in this discipling relationship, what has it been like? You guys talked about certain things, looked at certain Bible passages, or what have you done during the time?
Yeah, it's been kind of a two-way thing. I'm actually feel sometimes I'm getting discipled by Tim. But it's been, we kind of go over, lately we've been going over Bible verses, challenging each other to memorize, but also kind of meditate on the word a little bit more and just kind of how it applies to our life.
Okay.
And kind of holding each other accountable.
Okay. And what these guys share is they've both been sent. They've both been on the mission field, gone globally. So tell us a little bit about that.
Sure. Missionary faith. Well, honestly, yeah, I'm kind of embarrassed, but I'm not sure if I'm the best example of missionary faith. There are times when I went, but there was times when I honestly was wondering, gosh, it was so many things I was worried about on that trip. I was worried about the malaria, the typhoid, and the all these infections that you can get. And also the man had talked about getting stomach infections. I guess the previous team that had gone, they eating the village food and drinking the river water, getting stomach problems, and just being the whole new experience. So there was a lot of worries that I had, concerns, and when I told my mom, and she said, "Wayne, what are you doing?" And she even was raising more questions. Uh-huh. So there was times when I struggled, honestly, and but I went, and it ended up being a really God ended up being so faithful in that whole trip. That's why it was such a good trip.
Yeah. Just God. So you really learned a lot about your own personal faith, too. Yes, you got stretched a lot,
yes,
I would think.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
You came back alive, man. Yes. We have you. We're really happy that you came back alive. So you're in Thailand. Mm-hmm. And you also went to Thailand, is that right?
Yes, that's true. Yeah. So I had actually a very similar experience because, historically speaking, I actually didn't want to have anything to do with missions. I didn't want to do anything with full-time ministry, but I was just in a perfect place in my life at that time where I was just hungry, desperate to hear God's word, and I was sitting in there when the announcement was given, and it was one of those things where I just knew that I had to go, and I had a choice. I could either go in obedience and, you know, in faith, or I could struggle, continue to struggle with hearing God's voice and hearing His direction and leading. So, so I went, and it's like it launched me on the rest of my life journey, and I don't regret it at all. Yeah,
that's quite a statement.
Yeah.
So really, a big risk to even apply. It's not your world or what you thought of, but you took the step, and look what God has done with it. Pretty remarkable.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So as you guys have talked together, so you went to the same country at different years, mm-hmm. and as you kind of compared notes and talk, what have you learned about your faith and being sent and all, as you guys have talked about it?
Well, I think we both grew, I know I grew a lot in my trust, and I just saw how faithful God was on that whole trip. There's a lot of God things that happened, basically, that you just go, wow, thank you, God. Thank you, praise God. But and then Tim went and we shared a little bit, but he's now going to start going on looking into more long-term missions, so he's really carrying it one more step further.
Yeah. So just before we get to that, is there anything you talked about God things that were happening? Is there one story that you can tell us about the God things that are happening on the trip, either with you or with your team or with the villagers?
Sure. For example, we landed in the airport, and one suitcase was not there. And it happened to be Dr. Ken Kahara's old surgery stuff in there.
Oh, wow.
And it didn't, we went to the hotel, and we thought, wow, I guess we aren't supposed to do any dentistry on this mission trip. We thought, wow. And what happened was, we were supposed to go to the village the next day, and it rained, so the roads were muddy. And we had to delay it one day. And because we delayed it one day, the next day, Pastor A.G. happened to take us to some of the things, because he was a missionary there. He took us to some of his things that he did. We got back to the hotel. We got delayed one day, and that day, his suitcase arrived. And we just went,
yeah.
Wow. We got delayed one day because of the rain, but that's the day his suitcase came.
Right. Yeah.
And we just thought, wow, thank you, God. Wow,
yeah.
That was amazing.
Amazing.
We could have left without it, the suitcase.
Yeah.
But it came the next day.
And you're scheduled to leave, actually.
Yeah.
Wow.
So that was really...
That's pretty incredible,
yeah,
isn't it?
That's just one of the God things that happened.
Yeah. Okay. So, at this point in life, you guys are clearly at two different seasons of life, but you're both sent in different ways. So what is the transition that you're going through, Dr. Wayne?
Well, I'm more on the older side now, so I'm spending more time with my grandkids. I'm just about retired now.
Uh-huh.
I'm still serving on the missions committee. I'm discipling two people, Tim being one of them. I'm kind of trying to do that now. And I'm encouraging and supporting Tim with prayer and his ministry going on full-time mission.
Okay,
as we
great.
Meet. Yeah.
Okay. So you're still active, which is fantastic,
yes.
And still involved in missions and being sent.
Yes.
And you have a lot going on with missions and had some major things happen lately.
Yeah. So I just finished up with school. My last day was June 27th.
Wow.
So wrapped up my
thank
coursework.
God.
Yeah.
Relief.
So relieved to be finished. And I'm already looking to put it to work.
Tell us about your degree for those who might not know. What were you doing and studying?
Sure. I was studying linguistics and the biblical languages at Biola. And it was a master's degree program, and pretty much what it is preparation for doing Bible translation.
Yeah.
And studying linguistics, that kind of documenting undocumented languages. So studied that, and now I'm looking into going into full-time missions. Specifically have a heart for Mongolia and the Mongolian people, looking into that, joining up and going as soon as I can. Yeah.
So you went to Mongolia last year, is that right?
That's correct.
Yeah, last summer, if I remember right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So tell us a little bit about that. What was that like? Because you'd been to Thailand, mm-hmm. now you go into a different country, so different experience.
Yes, so going last year was, you know, Dr. Wayne had mentioned a lot about God things happening. It was a convergence of all of those different elements of my life. The Thailand trip had prompted me to feel called to go into full-time ministry as a missionary. This trip really confirmed it for me and confirmed my heart for these people. God had been putting the Mongolian people on my heart since I was about sixth grade, actually.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, long time.
That I did not know. Wow.
Yeah, and all of those things, I had kind of forgotten about it, and then it came back, and while I was there, opportunity after opportunity to see how I could fit in and where I could be serving them, and yeah, it was just a convergence, like I said, of all these different things in my life and interests that God had, you know, been brewing in me that I had no idea were going to be connected to missions later.
So as a sixth grader, you were interested in Mongolia. Probably kind of shelved it or went to the background of your life or whatever. And here it reemerges at a later time. Yeah. Isn't that wild?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Fascinating. So right now, as we think about the future, we want to pray for that. You're kind of exploring options. And obviously, this is an interesting season, right? Because I imagine a lot is on hold.
Yeah, for the most part. Mongolia, actually, as a country, has been doing really well with this situation. But, you know, if they don't receive flights from the U.S., then, you know, can't really do much there.
Yeah. Okay. So you're still definitely in the exploring stage and seeing kind of how that all unfolds in terms of when and how you'd go.
Yeah. In conversations with a couple of missions organizations, talking to Tommy Park with OMF, so, yeah.
Okay, great. So you guys have really been interesting that you began this relationship of discipling and you've learned from each other, but both also learned and grown a lot in your faith through being sent and being stretched in major ways. And you both made really uncomfortable choices to go on trips or to sign up and all, and God met you in a significant way. Mm. And you had a chance to see him work. Yeah. Fantastic. That's really great. You know, probably one of the most famous verses in the gospel is the last couple of verses, of course, of Matthew 28, where Jesus says to his disciples, "All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I'm with you always, even until the end of the age." So that sentness was instilled in the disciples early on. And as we look at this, of course, those 12 early disciples are called in the Gospels apostles. And we know that means sent ones. So the very name that they're given is what they do, being sent. And they're sent on mission. And those 12 original apostles, along with Paul, who's later also called an apostle, makes it really clear that that is in our DNA. That is what we're about. That is what we're supposed to do. So what is our response to this kind of sentness? One-time atheist and investigative journalist Lee Strobel, who became a believer, follower of Jesus as an adult, said, "I've seen far too many Christians who are willing to travel halfway across the world to volunteer to minister to strangers, but who can't bring it upon themselves to take the personal risk of sharing Jesus with a coworker who they sit side by side in the next cubicle." You know, being sent means that we need to befriend and love our neighbors, our colleagues. And even in these unusual, strange times, when we're all kind of keeping distance, there's still opportunity to love our neighbors and pray for them. Praying for them is hugely important. As pioneer missionary to Muslims, Samuel Zwemer said, "The history of mission is a history of answered prayer." That's where it begins. So as we conclude this episode talking about a missional faith, talking about sentness and that risk involved, which I'm really, really pleased to be with Wayne and Timothy, both who risked and became extremely uncomfortable in their exercise of a missional faith and being sent. It's something that we all want to emulate wherever God has placed us. So as we conclude this episode, you've noticed at the end of all of these, I close the words, keep the faith. And here I am, of course, referencing 2 Timothy 4:7, in which Paul looks back on his life of sentness and says, I have fought the good fight, I've finished the race, I have kept the faith. That's where I pull that of a life of sentness. And with that in mind, let's pray together, shall we? Lord, I thank you for Dr. Wayne and for Timothy and for their willingness to risk and to be sent, to live a missional life, a missional faith. And Lord, I pray that you would bless Dr. Wayne and his influence that he has in this new season of life, of just entering retirement, and those that he'll influence and be around, both friends and family. We ask that you would bless him in this season of sentness in a new and different way. And Lord, we thank you for Timothy's willingness to sign up for a trip that he really didn't want to do, and how that has changed the trajectory of his life. And Lord, we ask that you would bless him, that as he explores the possibilities with Mongolia and his heart clearly being implanted from sixth grade on for that people group, that you would bless him, that you would anoint that, you would guide and direct his steps during the season. So be with both of these men who have lived a missional faith and bless them. And I pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. So thank you guys for being with me today and sharing just a little bit of your life and the risk there. And we hope it'll be an inspiration to all of you. And so all of you who are sent, keep the faith. It worship be the fuel for me.